What's happening in Qiyamah? Allah says, إِذَا رُجَّتِ الْأَرْضُ رَجَّ. رَجَّ in Arabic language means to shake, to convulse, to shake uncontrollably. رُجَّتِ الْأَرْضُ رَجَّ. The word رَجَّ and رَجَّ, both words are from similar root word, same root word. When you use the same word twice, again it creates emphasis. أَرْض means the earth. رُجَّتِ الْأَرْضُ رَجَّ. Allah says, when the earth will shake uncontrollably. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, when geography lesson quickly, when you see tectonic plates and they go into one another, we see sometimes this shit, the ground becomes unstable. And we see that even if an earthquake lasts for about 10 seconds to 40 seconds, on the Richter scale, it causes millions and billions pounds of damage. Allah says that the earth will shake so badly on this day that it's never shook before. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have such a devastating effect. Allah dedicated the whole surah in regards to this. Surah إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. Allah refers to the same surah. Allah says, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ, when the earth will shake uncontrollably. وَخَرَجَ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا, and will begin to take up its load. Meaning, everything which has been buried, corpses which have been buried into the inside the earth, will begin to come up as it's begin to shake and people will be resurrected. يَوْمَذِي يَسْتَرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتَ, and you'll see people in distinct groups. Surah Waqi explains that. القرآن يفسر بعضه بعض. The Quran explains its own self in different parts. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا رُجَّتِ الْأَرْضُ رَجَّ. When the إِذَا means when, رُجَّتِ means will shake, convulse, رَجَّ, extremely, like violently, out of control. Allah says, as a result of this shaking, the earthquake, وَبُسَّتِ الْجِبَالُ بَسَّ. بَسَّ is used twice, just the way the word رُجَّ was used twice. وَبُسَّتِ الْجِبَالُ بَسَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's busa literally means to be reduced to smithereens and to be crushed and to be crumbled. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here that jibal is a plural of jabal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبُسَّتِ الْجِبَالُ بَسَّ. Allah says that these huge mountains you see around you, Allah says that these mountains will be shattered. Busa, reduced to smithereens. فَكَانَتْ هَبَاءً مُنْبَثَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that they will become haba, means dust. Haba means dust. فَكَانَتْ, Allah says it will become haba, means dust. مُنْبَثَّ means something which is scattered into the atmosphere. Haba is dust. مُنْبَثَّ refers to something which is scattered. Allah says, to put the translation together, Allah says when the earth will shake so like crazy, like violently, Allah says that these huge, massive mountains will be reduced to smithereens, to dust particles. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when the wind blows, these dust particles, these huge mountains will be reduced to dust. When the wind blows, these particles will be scattered into the atmosphere. Allah says, this is the reality of how Qiyamah is going to be taking place. And Allah is making us reflect, if huge, massive mountains, which nobody can physically move these days, Allah says in a matter of moments they're going to be reduced to rubble and nothing. People will actually not will even question whether a mountain was there in the first place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكُنْتُمْ أَزْوَاجًا ثَلَاثًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that now every single one of you أَزْوَاجًا ثَلَاثًا will be in ثَلَاثًا means three. Allah, here أَزْوَاج normally refers to a zawj, somebody refers to a couple, normally as well, normally refers to something which is in place. Allah says, Thalatha, Allah says, will be in three distinct groups. You'll be in three distinct groups. وَكُنْتُمْ, you will become azwajan, groups, Thalatha, three. So just very quickly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying here, when Qiyamah takes place, it will elevate a whole bunch of people, it will relegate a whole bunch of people. Allah says that earth will shake uncontrollably, and they'll be reduced to smithereens. فَكَانَتْ هَبَاءً مُنْبَثَّ. Allah says that these powders, smithereen, bits of mountain rubble will then be scattered into the atmosphere. And Allah says, on this day, every single human being from the time of Adam alayhi salam to the last dude who steps foot on this earth will be divided into three distinct groups. Now in this world, we sometimes break down people's, we classify people mentally, we verbalize it sometimes, psychologically, we break people down into groups. You know, we sometimes categorize people in terms of their wealth, sometimes in terms of their profession. So Sometimes it comes to the size of their house or the car they seem to be driving, or their language, their ethnicity, their geographical location. These are sometimes of some importance to us, so we can make sense out of people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know what, I don't care about your wealth. I don't care about how you look. Allah does not look at your physical appearance. Allah is not superficial, nor does He look at your bank balance. Allah says, Allah looks at your intentions in your heart, and He's going to be looking at your actions. Before you go on holiday, you don't go to the bureau exchange. You don't swap currencies. The currency of the hereafter will be deeds. The currency of the hereafter will be only be deeds. And the angels will actually be doing this currency exchange. People will come on the day of Qiyamah and present excuses to Allah. Allah says this in the end of the fourth juz. Allah says that people will come and say, oh Allah, let me bring my wealth back from this dunya. Give me an opportunity. Let me go back. Let me bring the wealth which I had left behind, which I was so busy and preoccupied that I became so heedless of your commandments. Let me go back to earth. Let me bring this wealth and let me ransom myself. Allah says, you know what? Allah says, you know, even if you could turn the whole world to gold, which you can never do, Allah says, even that will not be accepted to ransom yourself, because now you've got to pay for your actions. So the currency of the hereafter will only be action. Allah says, every single person will be in three distinct groups. Three distinct groups. Right, anyone missed any words? Till then? Quickly? You will become. Kuntum is a plural. Any other words we missed? We good? Right, continuing. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that every single person will be in three distinct groups. For ashabul maymana, ma ashabul maymana. You know the people of the right? Ashab means the people. That's where the word sahaba comes from. Ashab, the people of the right. Ma, the word ma is used so many times in the Quran. That's what I'm saying. If you don't have a background understanding of the Quran, the connotation sometimes you won't even understand. Ma can be used for in a negative sense. It can also be used for ta'ajjub, for astonishment. Allah says, for ashabul maymana. Maymana, for the word, you mean the people of the right. I'm explaining what the right means here. For ashabul maymana, ashab the people, maymana, the right. The people of the right, ma ashabul maymana. How amazing are the people of the right? How lucky, how fortunate. These guys are amazing, are the people of the right. These guys are just top marks for them. Ma, that's the translation of mother. Ma ashab al-mu'min. How amazing are the people of the right? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa ashabul mash'ama. And the people of the left. Ma ashabul mash'ama. Same ma is used for ta'ajjub, but in lizzajr is used in tafsir. In order, with tawbikh, literally in order to disgrace them, Allah says, the people of the left. How wretched, how unfortunate, how unlucky are these people of the left. So the people of the right, how amazing are the people of the right? The people of the left, how unfortunate, how unlucky are the people of the left? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves the last to best. The best to last. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ سَابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ. In Arabic language, it means that سَابِقُ يَسْبُقُ سَابِقُ يُسَابِقُ, literally means to overtake. Remember back in the days when they would be racing the camels, when they would say, like how we race cars these days? We shouldn't be, but if we are. When you overtake someone, I just beat you, I just overtook you. سَابَقْتُكَ, you would say, I've overtaken. They would use this kind of words when they would be racing with one another. Allah uses the same word in the Quran. Allah says, أَسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ. Allah says, these people, the people, the forerunners, the VVIPs, barakallah, these guys are the ones who have overtook the whole of humanity. These guys, the whole of humanity was kind of on the slow lane. These guys were on the fast lane the whole life. In terms of actions, Allah says, أَسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ, the formal translation, the forerunners. أَسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ, the VIPs, the VVIPs. The people who took over the whole of humanity in terms of actions. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes into detail to explain what these people will receive. Allah mentions them last to make you think. This is how revelation was coming down. People think, okay, people of the right, now the people of the left. Who are these? Another group, there's two groups. And then Allah says, you know what, you're waiting for this last group? These group are the special people. And let me quickly explain to you what right and left means. On the day of Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's arsh will go down strong. that there's two opinions in regards to what the people of the right mean. Both are valid, and both can actually complement one another. Opinion number one is that the people of the right are called the people of the right because they will receive their actions in their right hand, which will indicate their entry into Jannah. The people of the right are referred to as the people of the right because they will receive the book of deeds in their right hand, which will indicate their entry into Jannah. And the people of the left also referred to as the people of the left because they will get their actions of deeds in their left hand, and they will be indicating that they're going to be getting a one-way ticket to hell, no return. And they will end up there forever and ever. Opinion number two is they call the people of the right and the people of the left is because when Allah's arsh will be presented on the day of Qiyamah, these people will be on the right-hand side of the arsh of Allah. Right-hand side of the arsh of Allah. And the people of the left will be on the left-hand side of the arsh of Allah. وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ The VIPs will be right directly in front of the arsh of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ The next verse says, these people, أُولَٰئِكَ all of these people, مُقَرَّبُونَ They will be brought in proximity to Allah. They will be brought in closeness, in qurba to Allah. They'll be very close physically. Yeah, in terms of the groups will be a bit back, people on the left will be there, people on the right will be here. The sabiqun, the sabiqun will be in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walaikum muqarrabun. Two opinions. Right, opinion.